Hello everyone, and welcome to Season of Watch. Today we're watching I'm the Villainess, so I'm Taming the Final Boss, Episode 4. So, last episode we had a resolution of basically everything we got on the first three episodes. We got the ball that Eileen went, and she finally dissolved the engagement with Cedric officially. With it, Cedric also saw how she moved on from him. She has no interest in him anymore. One sec. Also, we got the company that she funded for cosmetic also profiting with the whole ladies just creating business for her because her strategy to sell only some of them. And we also got the resolution of what about the threatening letter that Lily was getting? Well, turns out it was Lily herself that was making them. Even Claude realized that and noticed that she was the one there when she visited the castle. The curious thing about her is that Eileen pointed out that she's a heroine, and so with the specific line, she can conquer any of the main characters, main male characters, such as Cedric, Claude, and probably some others. And so she was saying some lines about Eileen capturing her, still in love with Cedric, and also how she cared about Claude and was worried about him. Like, that came out of nowhere and seems very out of place. Like, she's saying specific stuff from the Otome game, huh? So yeah, my guess is that she's somebody else that got reincarnated into the game and is just trying to get it all, really. I was suspicious from her from the start. So we got that going on. And something else that's going on is that Eileen remembered why Claude just went berserk and rampage, turned into a dragon, telling a bunch of people, including her in the future, was because he got betrayed by the only human he trusted. Well, the only one I can think of is Keith. I don't think it's Cedric. Now, I'm curious as why Keith would betray him. Because he seemed like such a good aide to him. Like, he helped him out so much. All the praise he got, I think, was episode 2? Like, all the work he had been able to put into it. So maybe this episode we're gonna, like, dive into that. Now that Eileen remembered that, maybe she's gonna try to learn more about Keith, on why would he betray Claude, on how can she avoid that to happen. That's my guess. But who knows what's gonna happen. Maybe something new, completely new is gonna happen. That's gonna be our new focus. So yeah, without further ado, as a reminder, this is a time reaction, which means you sync up your own version of mine and we'll watch it together. I'll try to add some scenes here and there, but don't expect too much. And with that being said, let's get started. 3, 2, 1, go. Is this Claude and Keith's backstory? So maybe we are going to be focused on Keith this episode.
Yeah.
So why would you betray him? Oh, Keith sleeping in the city? Highly. She's being very forward in this plan. Oh, Belle's here as well. Oh, she's just straight up going for it. I thought she was going to be investigating, but no, oh, she's going threatening. Oh yeah, episode 4, I can't watch this. I was about to turn away. I finally gonna hear the music and see the animation of the opening. There's Ribbon and Almond. And all these cookies. Very high beat. Okay, I was about to say, like, it's like it's telling a story at a very fast pace. And they don't buy. Lily and Cedric. Yeah, Cedric is still spiteful, so he's definitely gonna be an antagonist still. Because of the whole everything being taken by his brother. Look at all her helpers there. Especially Isaac. Isaac's like. It's so weird, like there's this moment where the lyrics go super fast. And it's not like a rap. It's just like fast forward, really. And she's in a bride costume. I mean, to be fair, she was proposing to Claude in the very beginning. How he was able to get that land for Claude? Don't worry about it. And then can no longer his negative emotions. And that would be when he betrays her. And because of that, Lily would be able to defeat him. Yeah, that would hurt them a lot. Keith Aigrid. I don't think we ever got his last name. I probably won't remember it. So why are you doing this behind his back then? That's a garden pond? I mean, to be fair, it took a couple of years. Yeah. I'm gonna be quiet and waiting for him to tell his story. You included? That's sad and ironic. Yeah, being there, he's surrounded by demons. But hey, she's another human that's staying there. And she brought a bunch of humans with her, unlike you, who's the sole human there. Cedric route. Ah, she's thinking of the branching path of the game. Wow. That is not quite what you expect from an Otome game. Yeah, if that is, then it's kind of like all jam-packed right at the end. the Oberon Company. And what is your trump card? She always has a plan. This is a girl with a plan. Keeps a trump card. He became one of her underlings. Because he does care about Claude, just. That was fast. Those soldiers with Lilia, or just Lilia, Cedric, and who's that guy? Yeah, she's rushing through that route. Yeah, see, she's really following the game route. Not really aggression. Yeah, moral, but like I said, moral. She's playing the role of villainous. Like, even her voice, you can tell. Was that to get Lilia to leave? However, I wonder what this job is. Yeah. Which makes, like, he really cares about Claude, which makes that whole betrayal all the more sad. So he's gonna be faking the deal, I'm guessing. Like, this is how he was supposed to be making a deal, but now. Oh wow, they volunteered. Yeah, I mean, basically he was stuck in a hard rock, between a rock and a hard place, and he did the best he could with what he had. Yeah, petting him is... He's gonna end up conquering not only Claude, but Bao and Keith as well. Duke, Doc. Oh, wasn't that her dad or something? Why is he carrying the account book with him there? That's like the signal flare? Or just a flare in general? And that was very easily taken. Okay, Keith. one hand beat all three with them having a knife and you're empty handed. Oh, what more do you have there, huh, mister? Okay, what is... Yeah, the non-aggression pact. They're not directly doing that. Yeah. Look, the whole, sure, like, they could have been there all along, but I feel like the Dutch thing is a little stretching the non-aggression pact. Because she's not a game character, she is an actual person. And look who it is, the guy that was with Lilia and Cedric. Nope, Belfort, stand down. Yeah. Don't you remember when you touched her last episode? See, okay, he's... See, the evil smile and everything, he's... He went crazy, basically. Yeah, the Prince Cedric is now the villain of the story. Keith. Yeah. I only read the last part, which was explained in this episode. And he's explaining it himself. And I know where the tea leaves are. I heard you. I just don't know how to make it, but I know what they are. What is this way? Oh, Dad, I do not like the look of this. You're taking off your shirt. She's trapped. Handcuffed to the bed. Look how his face is. Like, man, it's almost like you have fallen for him, you know? Crazy. Helmet. I'm surprised how he was able to find her. And just like that, there goes the walls. He's very mad. Yeah. You're very important to him. Oh, hold on. Calm down. Let's not go full demon here. Yeah, he's going half demon. Yeah, because now there's not just one human that he cares about, there's two of them.
これで兄上もおしまいだ。
Ah, so they use her as hostage to get him. Good try, Almond. I'm not... Okay, good. Good job, Almond. Okay, Eileen, you gotta calm him down. It's crazy that this is episode 4 and all this stuff's already happened. Like, last episode, now this episode. Like, we're only on episode 4. What are we gonna have for the rest of the season? Yeah, because you guys forced his hand. How does that work? Like, it is the holy sword. Okay, it doesn't work on humans. Okay, that's... I hope that's true because it's hurting a lot. Yeah, I was about to mention that she also has a blood. Because she mentioned that in the first episode when she was going to the Demon Lord's territory. Which is interesting, because Lilia is supposed to be the hearing, and she's a villainess. But she even calls herself the main character. Or would that be a little fourth wall breaking? Okay. Her tears are gonna bring him back. Notice how he transformed, yet didn't really do anything as a dragon. Oh, like crystals falling off. Oh, the crystal around him. Is he naked, or does he have... Considering her reaction, I'll take that as my answer. Oh, yeah, of course. He got the right to inherit the throne. Yeah, I imagine he doesn't really care. Yeah, because she was working hard for Zedric. So it's basically forcing Claude's hand to be the emperor. I don't want to be emperor. I'll only give my daughter's hand to the emperor. Okay, I'm the emperor then. And the new coronation. Like, this is episode 4, not episode 12. Like, I would expect this, like, this event to be happening on the final episode, but we're one third of the way. But that's good that he was able to get back to the crown, being crown prince. After all, he is the first son. Yeah, look at you three. I still don't know the other guy's name. Kind of hard for her to run away. Oh. That is sweet. And they just disappear, teleported somewhere. The CGI horses. What? Oh yeah, let's see the ending. The princess encaged. The people. And that's Cedric and Lilia. And that's she falls from grace, which was the very beginning of the series. The crows. And then she goes for Claude. And basically purifying him. Or maybe that was just him leaving. Hard to say. I don't. Her in the chest at sea, running on gears. What do those mean? Okay, is she going somewhere? Going after the dragon? Going after Claude? He's spinning with the roses. Back. Oh, we're repeating. Oh, it's a little different now. Then she's going to the castle. Okay. What now? Like, this whole thing happened in the span of 4 episodes. I would be fine if it was in the span of 12 episodes. Granted, we would get some more stuff in between and them. But like that plot of this episode was basically a season finale. Yet we're one third of the way. What are we gonna have then? At the end, who was that? Was that Eileen or was that a new character? Because the voice did not sound like Eileen, but the character did look like her with short hair. Hopefully she did not cut her hair, because I would hate that so much. Like, maybe a brother coming back from distant land. But okay, now we're gonna step into a complete different territory, unknown territory, because the whole plot setup that we had, oh yeah, that's done already. We solved that. It's over. That is so crazy for me. Like, what? Well, let's go over this episode to get the events in line. So after she remembered that Keith would betray Claude, she went to research that and then went up to Keith herself with Belphegor to what's the word? Question him, really. And ask him about all that, and she learned the details of what happened. Like, he was healing demons, but that's only because he was kind of stuck in a situation after the guy was cheaping out from the land that he sold them before. And that was really the only reasonable solution he had. Though he did still work hard to make that as reasonable as possible. Like when she mentioned that he pressured them to treat them well, he got demons that volunteered to help, so it wasn't like he was just capturing them and they were like in panic and had no idea what was going on. So that's helpful.
クロード様は私の命の恩人なんです。どういうことですか。買った土地から立ち退けだなんて。これはわしのサインではない。まあ金になる魔物を売れば見逃してやらんでもないがな。あいつは仲間を売っていたんだよな。魔物は魔王のためならと 自ら進んで売られていったそうよ。キース様は取引後も可能な限り圧力をかけていたようだし。
And after she learned that, she found a way to help him out so that he would stop doing that, because he really does care about Claude. Like, he was doing that for Claude. In fact, he considers humans to not be great people, which ironically he was even saying, like, maybe Claude would be better off as just a demon and give and like step away from his human self, says the human. Like, that says a lot. Meanwhile, Lilia and Cedric both were plotting against Claude there, and Eileen away as well. Lilia with the whole plot of her to become, I guess, to become the Empress, and Cedric just like that fixation of vengeful fixation, really, both on Claude and on Eileen. Because so they attack them, like, you could tell something was going on when she thought Lily would be hiding the bushes and she wasn't there. You could tell something was going on there, that Lilia and the other had a plan. But yeah, they just attacked them, so they took Eileen captive. And I don't even want to talk about what Cedric was trying to do with her, because he was just fixated on making her like his second wife, because he still wanted her as his possession, even though she left him. Or rather, he expelled her instead of having leftover feelings. She moved on quickly, so he's still spiteful. And was a two-in-one situation. Two birds, one stone, because that way Claude would come all angry to go after them, since he cared about Eileen, not just Keith anymore. And turn full demon, that way Lily could defeat him, and she would be qualified to become the Empress. Therefore, she would get her wish, he would get vengeance on his brother, and he would force Eileen to become his second wife. That was their whole plan there, but Eileen just took charge of the whole situation. Like, she stopped. Well, first of all, good job, Alma, to break those chains with her beak. I honestly was underestimating you. I did not expect you would be able to do that. I was about to call you out, like, as much effort as you're putting there, I don't think that's gonna work. And then he just went ham on it and broke it. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna shut up. But yeah, she got in the way of Lilia stabbing Claude. Because, so I was worried about the Holy Sword thing, because I didn't know how it worked. But then she explained that it did not work on humans. And like, oh, that better be true, because it hurts like hell. Like, that was great. But yeah, she took in the sword herself, After all, she does have the Holy Maiden's blood. She mentioned that on the first episode. Maybe she doesn't have as much of the Holy Maiden's blood as Lilia, but she still have part of it. That's why she was able to take it, but she didn't have it. And then she used her love to get Claude back, because when she was captured, she realized that she did love Claude. It wasn't just a means to save herself, but she actually fell in love with him.
やっぱり夫婦生活が大変そうじゃありません。魔物と人間が一緒に暮らす幸せだってきっと叶えてみせるから。君の反応が楽しいんだ。嫌なら逃げてみるといい。逃げる？おかしなことをおっしゃいますわね。
So then, after that was all solved, even though Cedric's plan did not come into light to the public, Claude was able to reinstate as a crown prince. Even though he didn't want it, he did it for Eileen because her dad wanted her to marry the emperor. But that was a pretty funny scene. It was basically, oh, you can become the emperor now. I don't want to be the emperor. Oh yeah, I want the best for my daughter, and that means I'll only allow her to marry the emperor. Very well, I'll be the emperor then. And yeah, they had him become the crown prince again. I don't know if we'll say that he straight up became emperor or just was officially the crown prince, a to be emperor, and she was his maiden, his should be queen. And they even have that lovely moment there, so that was in, except not really, because that was episode 4. Like, that still baffles me that we got all that done in episode 4. We still have 8 more episodes. I think it's 12 episodes. What are we gonna have for all this upcoming episodes? Well, I guess I'll just have to wait and find out. So with that being said, see you next time. Bye.